This video is brought to you by Skillshare. Electric vehicles are gaining in popularity, but not everybody's on board. One of the big perceived drawbacks is how long it takes to charge them and having access to somewhere where you can plug in to get that charge. If you live in an apartment building or the city, charging can get a bit challenging. But what if you didn't have to plug in your car to charge? Some companies have solar-powered cars available for pre-order today, but what's the reality behind these cars? Can they really provide enough power to fit the bill and at a cost that won't break the bank? I'm Matt Ferrell. Welcome to Undecided. The automotive industry is still in the early phases of transitioning over to electric completely, which will most likely take another decade or two. Now we're seeing the rate of adoption towards battery electric vehicles increase. Between 2020 and 2021, EV sales around the globe jumped 108%, reaching 6.75 million units in 2021. Out of those, 71% were full battery electric vehicles, not hybrids. For comparison, in 2012, the total number sold was 125,000. However, battery electric vehicle manufacturers still have challenges around consumer perception on issues like short driving range and long charging times. And that's where solar power may have a few advantages. Now, I've seen this question raised on a bunch of my electric vehicle videos. Why not just stick solar panels in your car? With a significant decrease in solar panel costs, a lot of EV charging locations and parking lots are installing solar canopies. I see them a lot around where I live. Now, integrating directly onto the car itself seems like a great option, because in theory, you wouldn't need to even plug your car in the first place. But there's a catch. There's always a catch. First, let's take a step back and look at when the concept of adding solar panels to your cars began and how it's fared so far. The history of solar-powered cars goes back to the 1950s with William G. Cobb from General Motors. And granted, calling this a car might be a little bit of a small exaggeration. It was a tiny 15-inch model car powered by 12 selenium photovoltaic cells and an electric motor. More like a car for squirrels. Now, the first human-sized model showed up in 1962. It was a 1912 vintage Model Baker that was converted by an international rectifier and powered with 10,640 individual solar cells. Now, if we jump ahead to 1980, a team from Tel Aviv University in Israel developed a solar car that was powered with 400 watts of solar cells, but it wasn't exactly a beautiful car. It was a car only a mother could love. Now, with solar panels strapped under the roof and hood, it had a range of about 50 miles and a top speed of about 40 miles per hour. It wasn't going to win any races or gain any points for style. In the years that followed, most solar-powered cars were designed at universities for racing purposes and pushing the technology forward, but none could be considered a viable passenger vehicle. Things like range and weight capacity just weren't there. However, in the last few years, some companies are starting to push that idea that solar panels on cars might be viable for a consumer product. Solar-powered cars offer several benefits, just like any other battery-powered EV. They're silent, have zero emissions, and require less maintenance compared to internal combustion vehicles. And recharging the batteries with solar power from the car's roof can lead to fewer charging stops. If the car could be completely charged from the sun, there would be no fueling costs to run the car, in theory. The question remains, can solar panels actually provide enough power? Well, in a nutshell, solar panels generate electricity to charge a battery pack, which in turn is used to provide the power needed to move the car. While some of the prototype cars from the universities I mentioned directly power the car from solar panels without the need for a battery, the cars coming to market still all use battery packs. Now, all of these cars can still be plugged in and charged up like any other EV. Now, although there's a massive amount of energy to be extracted from the sun, current solar cell technologies still have fairly low efficiency, usually around 15 to 25% for solar panels, which can make the math for how much electricity you can generate given the amount of space a bit challenging. Cloudy weather, haze, low sun angles, and other issues mean that you might not generate enough electricity to charge the batteries. So let's break that down and attach a few numbers to the problem. How much area is available for solar panels on a car? Now, I'm not a mathematician, but let's use the same line of thinking as Engineering Explained when he tried calculating this, with some modifications. Let's use the top area of a Tesla Model 3, which is about 8.7 square meters. And let's say about 60% of that area is usable roof space. If we cover that entire area with solar panels, in the perfect scenario, where we'd be making flat earthers happy using a cross-section of the Earth, the energy coming from the sun would be about 1.36 kilowatts per square meter. The solar panels could generate about 7.1 kilowatts in total. For a 75 kilowatt-hour battery pack, the solar panels could fully charge the batteries in about 10 and a half hours. I'm not a flat earther, and we'll be driving this fictional car on the surface of a sphere, which means we'd only get about 340 watts per square meter. But it actually gets worse than that. Only about 55% of the sun's irradiance would hit the car's surface, since a significant portion is reflected back into space or absorbed by the atmosphere. So a 20% efficient solar cell would give us about 37.4 watts per square meter in a more realistic scenario. We also need to consider the efficiency of the battery charging system. Let's be generous and say it's 95%. The results? About 185 watts. To fully charge a Tesla Model 3's battery pack, you might need about 405 hours. That's about 17 days to fully charge the car. Not bad if you drive them frequently, but impossible if you have a regular Monday to Friday commute. And the results may vary depending on your location, which impacts the sun's angle on the solar panels, time of year, weather. You get the idea. You're not going to be 100% independent from plug-in charging. Now, all of this sounds like a pretty damning conclusion that solar panels on a car just don't make sense. Even so, the companies that are starting to push this technology are tackling a few things my extremely rough math haven't factored in. Before we get to that, and also related directly to it, if you really want to learn more about engineering and designing solar energy systems, you might want to check out the Ultimate 2021 Solar Energy Course for Electrical Engineering at Skillshare. It's one of the many reasons I'm so happy to have Skillshare sponsoring this video. If you're anything like me, then you like learning new things, and Skillshare has built an incredible online learning community with thousands of classes to learn new skills in a wide array of topics. For me, I've been trying to streamline my YouTube video production process, and one of the classes I keep coming back to is Marques Brownlee's YouTube Success Script, Shoot, and Edit with MKBHD. It's probably obvious why I'm interested in this, but I'm always trying to find that thread or story to weave through each video, just like this one. It's been super helpful for me. Everything on Skillshare is focused on learning, so there aren't any ads, and they're always launching new premium classes. Every time I log in, there's something new that catches my eye. And for the non-English speakers out there, the entire catalog is available with subtitles in multiple languages. The first 1,000 people to use this link will get 1 month free trial of Skillshare. Thanks to Skillshare and to all of you for supporting the channel. Now back to the companies pushing solar technologies on EVs. In 2017, the German startup Sono Motors unveiled their first prototype of an electric car with solar recharging, the Scion. The EV has 248 solar cells integrated into the body of the car that can boost driving range by 112 kilometers, or about 70 miles, each week on average. But it could go as high as 245 kilometers, or about 152 miles per week, in peak conditions. Using a fast charging station to top up, Scion takes about 35 minutes to fill the 54 kilowatt hour battery pack to 80% state of charge. The total driving range for the car is about 305 kilometers, or about 190 miles, and has a top speed of 140 kilometers an hour, or about 87 miles per hour. Now, Sono Motors has already made pre-orders available for Scion, but the production isn't set to start until 2023, with a purchase price of 28,500 euros, or about $32,000. The company plans to deliver the first 14,000 reservations in 2023. In addition, they're also evaluating solar integration into large vehicles. For example, integrating thin-film solar panels onto a truck with a 13-meter trailer under peak conditions in Munich, the roof and sides equipped with solar cells could generate 82 kilowatt-hours per day. This could result in up to an 80% saved energy cost for refrigerated trailers compared to diesel. Now, there's also the SUV market. In 2021, Fisker revealed the Ocean SUV with a solar roof. The company's Solar Sky roof technology can produce energy to provide between 1,500 and 2,000 miles, or about 2,400 and 3,200 kilometers a year. They have models with driving ranges between 250 and 440 miles. They start at $37,000 and go up to about $69,000. Now, the start of production is scheduled for the end of 2022, and they just recently announced that they have over 31,000 reservations. That's about $1.7 billion in potential revenue. Now, again, you're not going to cover all of your daily driving needs, but it makes a small dent in it. Now, another company developing solar electric cars is Lightyear, which unveiled the Lightyear 1 in 2019. Now, this is where the potential range generated per day takes a turn. Their long-range solar electric car has 5 square meters of patented double-curved solar array that achieves a 215 watts per square meter. Now, according to the company, 1 hour in the sun can provide about 12 kilometers or about 7 miles of range. And at the end of the day, that can result in about 70 kilometers or about 43 miles. That's basically the average number of miles driven per day in the US. One of the big reasons for that high range added per day doesn't come from the solar panel efficiency, but the car's efficient use of that energy. It uses about 83 watt hours per kilometer. Now compare that to a Tesla Model 3 at about 167 watt hours per kilometer. It's expected to reach a driving range up to 725 kilometers or about 450 miles based on the Worldwide Harmonized Light Vehicle Test Procedures, which is the WLTP. So take that with a grain of salt until we see the real world results. The downside for those incredible numbers? the selling price of their car is about 150,000 euros, which is equivalent to $170,000, excluding taxes, but it's expected to be available to customers starting this summer. On the flip side of those great mileage and efficiency numbers are some of the bigger auto manufacturers like Hyundai and Mercedes, who seem to just be slapping solar onto existing designs. A limited edition version of the 2022 Hyundai Sonata Hybrid is equipped with a 22.8% efficient solar roof that under ideal conditions will increase the driving range by 2 miles per day. This kind of highlights the difference between slapping solar panels onto an unoptimized car design versus building a new solar-powered car from the ground up with efficiency first. However, these are a bit easier on the wallet, starting at about $35,000. Now, Mercedes Vision EQXX is in a similar boat, albeit a little bit better for range added. The 117 solar cells on its roof will provide about 25 kilometers or about 15 miles of extra range in a day, under ideal conditions. But this brings us to the solar-powered car company that really lights up the competition, Aptera Motors. This is where the think-outside-the-box, build-from-the-ground-up approach really does hit its stride. This futuristic three-wheeler has been designed to be extremely energy efficient, being able to reach up to 1,000 miles on a single charge. One of the keys to that incredible range is its lightweight, weighing 65% less than a common EV. Combine that with its efficient drivetrain and aerodynamics, and you're using only 30% of the energy of current EVs and hybrids. This is not just about slapping solar panels onto a car, but rethinking the whole approach. So how much range would you get with 700 watts of solar cells? Well, I live in Massachusetts, so let's use that as an example. If I drove 30 miles a day, considering the local lake conditions, I may only need to recharge the Aptera about twice per year, in theory. It's capable of providing 16 to 40 miles of extra range to the car, depending on the conditions. Now, after some fits and starts, the company finally opened up pre-orders in December of 2020. Aptera's production and first deliveries are expected to start this year with a price range from $25,000 to about $50,000. That's the best price to range of the entire lot, but it's also an incredibly unique looking car, which might not be your cup of tea. Now, the big issue with most of these models is that they can't be completely solar powered, but they can make a dent in the amount of plug-in charging that you'd need. There's also the issue of limited real estate available for solar cells to be integrated onto the surface of the car. Transparent solar panels could be used for vehicle windows to produce power, but as we saw in my video on that technology, current transparent cells have a much lower efficiency and power density than silicon cells. The combo of limited surface area, low solar panel efficiency, and vehicles that aren't designed from the ground up with this in mind makes this not as compelling from a cost-benefit perspective. However, for vehicles that are purpose-built for this, like Aptera or Lightyear, the numbers look a lot more appealing. So do you want to own a solar-powered car? Do you think we'll see more of this in the future? Jump in the comments and let me know. If you have knowledge of this or you work in the industry, please share your experience so we can learn more together. You can also join my Discord server and talk to other members of the community, and the link's also in the description. And thanks, as always, to my patrons, and a big welcome to new producers For Fission Not Fusion and David Haley. All of your direct support really helps with producing these videos and to reduce my dependence on the almighty YouTube algorithm. Speaking of which, if you like this video, be sure to check out one of the ones I have linked to right here, and subscribe and hit that notification bell if you think I've earned it. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one.